Welcome children, once again to this video edition. And today we are going to start with the organic practicals, where you are going to identify an organic compound based on your observation and identification of the functional groups. For the same, if we have to look into the syllabus, the compounds that you have to do are, I will just upload the file. So this is it, video for the chemistry practicals, CISC code 2020, identification of the organic compounds for class 12. Now if you look into the syllabus, you will see that in the syllabus, the question number, the topic number 3, I must say, is identification of the following compounds is given. Alcoholic group, glycerol you have to do, aldehyde group, formaldehyde you have to do, bromine group, acetone, carboxylic group, benzoic acid, and amino group, it is aniline. And of course, you also have to do the characteristics test for carbohydrates and proteins, for which we will be going towards the end. Now, in this practical session or in this video edition, we will start first with the groups and the introduction to this. Now, in organic chemistry, we have already studied that all these functional groups have characteristic tests. If you can just take a minute to look at the groups that have been mentioned. So the first one is the alcoholic group. In a dry test tube, you have to take 2 ml of the substance with small amount of anhydrous calcium chloride, shake well to remove the moisture from the substance and decant the liquid in a dry clean test tube. Add to it a clean piece of metal sodium effervescence with evolution of hydrogen into its alcohol. So you see in that there is a particular test in each of these groups which help you to identify that the given organic compound belongs to which class of organic compounds. Like we have a special test for the ketonic group, we will have a special test for the aldehyde group, and along with these tests are the other tests given which are primarily for identifying the compounds. So if we go to the next slide, and this is from the book, straight away the one book I had. The first organic compound that we have to do is glycerol. Now if you look into the glycerol, number of these experiments have been written. So we will basically be doing the ones which have been ticked, and normally you get about 3 to 4 tests per compound, out of which one test is definitely for identifying the functional group and one test is there as an identification test for that particular compound. So we have the compounds like glycerol and aniline. So you can see the experiments are given there for aniline also. Can see number of experiments are given. I'm not reading out these. You will have to copy down these in your note copies, and I will show you how to do the writing also. So this is about the aniline. The next compound, this is the last 2 experiments of aniline that we have to do. The experiment on the observations are given, and while we do the experiment, you will be able to see the color actually, you know, forming or the precipitate forming. The next compound, the third compound, that is after the glycerol, the aniline, it is the formaldehyde. In the formaldehyde also, a number of tests are there. There is a test for identifying the group. Like for example, if you are taking the Welling solution test, the SCIS reagent test, these are the tests that help you to identify the aldehyde, especially the formaldehyde. Experiment number 7 basically is the test for the identification of formaldehyde. So these tests are there. The numbers written in red are the ones that have been marked for some reason, but actually the you see experiment number 5 has a cross there, so we may not be doing that experiment. Okay. The next is about acetone. And acetone, the first test is the iodoform test. Here also you can see only one line is written here. The following lines are in the next page. Here also the tests are written. I'm not going to read out the test. But the pattern of reporting your practicals will be in the same way. You will write experiment, then you will write the observation. Experiment, then the observation. And towards the end, it is the conclusion. Just after this, I will show you how to do that. After this, we have benzoic acid. Benzoic acid, just 3 tests are there. With the help of which, we will be able to identify the benzoic acid. And after this, we have the test for protein and carbohydrates, for which we will be testing for carbohydrate and protein both. We will be using milk to carry out the test. You can see there is a Milon's test written there. And of course, for the carbohydrate also it is there. Reading out the experiments will take a lot of time, so I'm not reading out, but it is right there in front of you. And of course, what I was telling you is how to report your organic practicals. That part I will just show you, and after that we'll start with the practicals, the live demo of the practicals. So you can see, suppose if you have been given organic compound, suppose the question says organic compound, alright, the question paper will say organic compound C1, let us say it is saying C1 or A1, whatever, okay. Then in the question paper, the tests will be given. So let us say 3 tests are given, first test, second test and the third test. And maybe, okay, let us say another 4th test is also given. So the experiment will be explained here. The details of the experiment will be given. Experimental details will be given. What you have to do, what you have to add. All right. And after that, you have to observe the changes that are happening. And based on that, you will identify. So your mode of writing will be, or your pattern of writing will be, you write the experiment. You will write the experiment number 1. You write experiment number 1. All right. Follow the same order that is given in the question paper. All right. This is for writing in the practical note copy. So you will write down the practical, the experiment. Then under this, you will write observation. So you will write down the observations. Similarly, you will do it for experiment number 1, 2 and 3. As many are given for you to do. So you can do that, and observation, this continues. Once all the experiments are over, then you will write down conclusion. Hence the given compound is, or based on the observation, the above compound is a glycerol or an aniline or benzoic acid, whatever it is. So this will be your pattern for writing. However, in the examination, you only have to report the observations. That I will explain in the class later on. This pattern you will follow for writing in the practical note copies. Okay, so I think we are ready to begin with the demonstration of the practicals. And so just give me 2 minutes to arrange the lab for the practicals. I have Thakur sir with me, who is going to help me out, or we are going to do it together rather for the experiments. Okay, children, we are ready with the practicals, and we have Sir Thakur who is going to demonstrate the organic chemistry practicals. Over to you, sir. It's simple. So the first,
the drops of borax.
And followed by?
Followed by the drops of phenolphthalein.
Okay.
Yes, sir. Then we are adding few drops of glycerol into it.
See, so we are doing the test that is called as
Yeah, it's called as the Dunstan's check, and we are going to take some borax. Into that we have added phenolphthalein, and you saw that the solution became colorless. Now it is supposed to be heated in a water bath. So sir is doing the warming part, and you will see that when it is warming, warm, you see the change. First you see the change, and then it will tell you what is happening. So you can see that it's show the pink color reappearing. You can see the pink color is reappearing, and then when it is cooled again, the color will disappear. So this is about the. This is actually a very important test for glycerol. All right. So we now move to this next test. In the next test, we are going to do phenol. Now this is going to be the next experiment is with copper sulfate, and it is experiment number 5 in the. It is experiment number 5 under the glycerol topic, and we are going to take 1 cm³ of copper sulfate. To this, we are about 4 drops of glycerol will be added, to which a few drops of sodium hydroxide will be added. So, sir is getting the solutions ready. This is with copper sulfate.
We are adding sodium hydroxide.
Yes. So, upon adding sodium hydroxide. See, a blue colored solution is formed. All right, this blue colored solution is giving a positive test that the given compound may be glycerol. The next test we will do is with is the pyrogelol test. Okay. So about 3 to 4 mL is taken. Sir, one second. It's not recording. All right, children, the next test that we will do is the Tollens reagent test for the glycerol. Okay, you can see sir is preparing the Tollens reagent by taking sir
ammonium hydroxide.
You see silver nitrate and ammonium hydroxide.
Now we are pouring a few drops of glycerol here.
All right.
And now making is made here.
So it has been kept in the water bath, and it is being warmed. It is supposed to be warmed for about 5 minutes. And while that is being done, we can continue with the next test. In the next test, we can take 2 ml of glycerol and mix it with 3 ml of caustic soda solution and shake. No change takes place. So this you can write, we are not doing the experiment out of. One was the Dunstan's check, where 1% solution of borax was taken, and to it was added a few drops of phenolphthalein, and when the pink color was formed. The second test was with the copper sulfate solution, and the third test is that with the Tollens reagent. And it's been a little while since we have been boiling the solution. Warming.
Okay.
You see the test. This is supposed to show that silver mirror test. Okay, if the silver mirror is not formed very, very like you, if you cannot see it, even the gray precipitate that is there, that indicates the presence of the aldehydic group. All right. So there is some silver. I don't know how clear it will come in the picture, but this is about the silver mirror test, and that is shown by Glacier. So once you have done all the three tests, then you can confirm that the given compound is a glycerol. The next compound that we will do is aniline. All right. कौन कौन सा करेंगे सर? Okay, children, the next is for the aniline. As we are doing, you can see we are adding aniline to the test tube. And sir, what are the reagents for this?
Bleaching powder.
Few drops of bleaching powder are being added. And to this, a solution of ammonium sulfide will be added. Few drops. You can see sir is taking that. Okay. So see the color change. Sir, can we bring it closer? You can see the color change. The change in color that you observe is, in this case, a violet coloration, which actually changes to brown, green, and then starts to fade away. However, on dilution and further addition of ammonium sulfide solution, intense red color is supposed to develop. So, sir, hora red. You can show them very close. This is the camera. Shake it up. You see the color. This is the intense red color upon dilution that you get. Okay. So that was the test for aniline. The next test that we will do is we'll add a few drops of potassium dichromate solution to aniline in dilute H2SO4, and the observation is a deep red color is produced, which soon changes to deep blue or black. That is called as aniline black. So that is a confirmatory test for aniline again. So we have this test that we are about to do. So aniline in a test tube. To this we are going to add potassium dichromate solution. Okay. Few drops of potassium dichromate. In presence of sulfuric acid. You can see a deep red color is produced, which soon turns to deep blue. A deep red color, which has just turned to deep blue. So that is the color change that you see. Sir, if I can just show that very closely. This is the black color. This is what is called as aniline black. All right. This is a kind of a confirmatory test for aniline. You can see it is turning so deep color. So this deep blue or black color is called as aniline black. The next test is with about 1 to 2 drops of the aniline, to which about a centimeter cube of concentrated hydrochloric acid is taken in a test tube. To this, we are going to add ferric chloride solution. To this, we will add ferric chloride solution.
Sir, ferric chloride.
Sir, up some. Okay. A few drops of ferric chloride solution. Concentrated hydrochloric acid in a test tube and add a few drops of ferric chloride solution. That is ferric chloride solution. A pale green color is supposed to develop. You can see that if you swirl the solution in the test tube, you'll be able to see the color. Okay. Slowly it will turn a pale green color. The next is we are going to take about 2 ml of the organic compound, and to this we will add sodium hypochlorite solution and shake. Sodium hypochlorite. Purple violet color is okay. You can see the color coming. Sir, if you bring it close to the camera, they'll be able to see the color. Can you see the color, children? It's turning violet. All right. A purple violet color is obtained. So with this, we can confirm with the test that we did just now, we can confirm that the organic compound given to us is aniline. The next compound that we will take up is formaldehyde. All right, so we will now start with formaldehyde. The first test we are going to do is take 1 ml of formalin in a test tube, to which a strong solution of pyrogallol will be added with excess of hydrochloric acid. So you can see the color is actually supposed to change to white, and then it is supposed to take a deep red. Actually, it just the change is so fast that it just changes to a deep red color immediately. All right. The deep red color is okay. So that is the deep red color that we are getting. A white precipitate is formed, which readily turns pink and then red. So that was the first test for formaldehyde. The next test that we have is with the felling solution. Now this is a kind of a confirmatory test for the aldehyde group. Because when we treat any compound containing an aldehyde group and treat it with felling solution A and B, which have been kept together there in a beaker, a red PPT of Cu2O is obtained. So you need to warm the solution and then leave it for a while when a red precipitate will be obtained. The next test that we will do is with the Skips reagent. Formaldehyde we can take in this. Formaldehyde. So we can see that the minute we are adding the Skiff's reagent and formalin together, we get a pink color of the original dye is restored. Actually, the color is of the Skiff's reagent, which is actually decolorized by passing SO2, but later on we get the pink color. That is why the word restored is used. Now let us see if this has given us the red 50. It is still being warm. And now the next test that we will do is with Tollens reagent. The next test is with the Tollens reagent. Sir, it tested with silver nitrate and ammonium hydroxide. We have already shown how to prepare that. So, sir is preparing the Tollens reagent. And in another test tube, we have formaldehyde. So we will be adding the Tollens reagent to formaldehyde and again allowing it to warm. So the two test tubes are there, and the last test is to 1 cm³ of the original substance, we'll add a crystal of resorcinol and shake. And then slowly add about 1 cm³ of or 1 cc of concentrated sulfuric acid along the walls of the test tube. Now this is an important test, children, you'll have to remember this.
Yes. This is
resorcinol. Resorcinol again. Check it up. To this, we are going to add 1 cm³ of concentrated sulfuric acid. This is a beautiful test. You are supposed to get a red ring formed at the junction of a liquid, and a white PPT is formed in the aqueous layer. So you can see that white PPT being formed in the aqueous layer, and there is a red ring that is formed at the junction of the two liquids. So this was a confirmatory test and for formaldehyde. And let us see if the other two tests are ready, sir. This is a CO2, that is the Felling solution test. If we bring it close, you can see the red precipitate in that. Can you see the red precipitate? It was a blue colored solution. It has started turning red actually. And then the other is the Tollens reagent test, which will take a little while. Maybe we'll be able to show you along with the next experiment. Okay, children, you can see now that a silver mirror has been obtained on the walls of the test tube. This is the confirmatory test for an aldehyde group, and we have confirmed the presence of the organic compound as formaldehyde. Okay, I hope you can see it. It's actually shining, and if I bring it very close, maybe you'll be able to see it. You can see that. All right. So this is it. So that was about formaldehyde. So next compound, what are we doing?
Acetone.
So we start with acetone, sir. What have we taken?
First few drops of acetone, followed by few crystals of iodine.
Okay. So we are going to perform the iodoform test, right?
First is this NaOH.
Nitroprusside test. Very slowly we have to add and leave it, because this is a yellow crystals of iodoform will be obtained. So we leave it for some time, or you want to shake it up? So heat gently and leave it for some time. Anyway, we have got it because it was already warm. So you can see the yellow precipitate has been obtained. That's iodine, which is being liberated. We can add more sodium ion. Okay, sir. So that was about iodoform test. The next we have to do is about we are going to take again 2 ml of the compound acetone in a test tube, and to this we will add about 0.5 ml of caustic soda solution followed by 2 to 3 drops of freshly prepared sodium nitroprusside solution. So this is acetone. To this we are going to add caustic soda solution. First, and to this 2 to 3 drops of freshly prepared sodium nitroprusside solution. All right, so a ruby red coloration is seen. The red coloration will fade to yellow and then disappear. So you can see the coloration. All right, that's a ruby red coloration. We'll leave it for some time and let us see if it disappears. In the meantime, we'll do the next experiment. The next, another test tube. A 1 ml of the original compound, to which we are going to add few drops of sodium nitroprusside followed by ammonium hydroxide solution, ammonia solution. Sodium nitroprusside, so we can add here. And to this we will add ammonium hydroxide. Ammonia solution. Sir is giving. All right. It is supposed to give a violet coloration. We'll wait for a while till it turns. And the color is not that clear that we can show you, but it's actually a violet color is produced, which disappears on warming and reappears on cooling. So we will a violet color which is produced, which is going to disappear on warming. So I'm going to warm it. In the meantime, we'll do the next. We'll get ready with the next test. Mercury chloride solution test. Just a little time, children, for just to get the experiment ready. You take about 5 cm, half cc of mercury chloride solution in the test tube. To this we will add solution of sodium hydroxide drop by drop, and after this we'll add original solution drop by drop. Mercury chloride solution. Yes. To this add dilute solution of sodium hydroxide. And to the above, so we'll add original substance drop by drop. Original substance drop by drop. Already. Okay, so you can see the yellow crystals are formed, which finally dissolve when original substance is added. So you saw that yellow color to this when it is added, it is supposed to dissolve slowly. We need to add more of it, or what? We'll throw half the color. So you can see now that yellow precipitate has dissolved. All right, so this is a confirmatory test again for acetone, and this is what the test is telling us, that the yellow crystals form finally dissolve when the original substance is added to it. So with this, the tests for acetone are over, and now we are just left with benzoic acid to be done, I think, and after that we'll do the carbohydrates and proteins. Okay, children, the next that we are going to do is benzoic acid, and you have seen that there are three tests in that. But we will not be conducting all the three tests because the smell of the ethyl benzoate, you know, will not be possible to show it here. The first is it dissolves in hot water. So you can see in hot water, sir has warmed the test tube. The warmed one is this solution. You can see it has dissolved in this. It's a clear solution. All right. And when it was cooled, sir, white flakes, you can see the white flakes in the beaker. All right, so this is one test, that the benzoic acid dissolves in hot water but separates again on cooling as a shining white flakes. The next test for this is we are going to test with benzoic acid with ferric chloride solution. So when ferric chloride solution is added to benzoic acid, you can see a buff colored precipitate is formed. All right, so this is a confirmatory test for benzoic acid. The third test is with on warming alcohol with concentrated sulfuric acid. We are supposed to get a sweet smell of ethyl benzoate. That is when you are warming benzoic acid with an alcohol in presence of concentrated sulfuric acid. It's the esterification reaction that takes place, and sweet smell of ethyl benzoate is perceived. Now, since we will not be able to, you know, show you how to, you know, how, I mean, what is the smell of ester? You know that it's a fruity smell of ester is obtained. So these three tests will confirm the benzoic acid. Now we will move to testing of carbohydrates and proteins. Okay, children, now this is the test we just performed because it was taking a little time. So we had to be very careful. You can see that violet ring that is formed at the junction of the at the bottom it is formed. Now this test is actually for testing of carbohydrates. So we took a sample of the milk, and to this we added alkaline solution of alpha naphthol, and to that when concentrated sulfuric acid was added, we got a very beautiful, you see, the violet pink color was obtained. All right, so this confirms that the given sample is containing carbohydrate. We'll now proceed for testing of the proteins. Now, if you want to see that one more time, you can see that color, that violet ring that has been formed at the bottom. So, children, we are ready with the protein experiment, and we have again performed the experiment. We are only going to show you the color. You can see that this is the violet coloration that is seen in this case. This test is of protein where we have taken 1 centimeter cube of the milk sample that we got from the market, and to this we have added alkaline solution of copper sulfate. Okay, and formation of a violet color, which I think has changed a little color also, but anyway, that's the violet coloration that is seen, is confirming the presence of protein in the milk. The next test is what sir has done. Sir has performed 1 centimeter cube of the milk sample in a test tube, and to this added about a centimeter cube of mercury chloride solution, boiled the solution, and formation of a red color shows the presence of protein. So you can see both the tests we have done, and with these two tests, the practicals on organic chemistry are almost done. We hope that you all have understood. We are not experts, so there may have been some little flaws here and there with the video preparation of the video. But anyway, we have tried our best, and so we have Srivastava sir, who's always there to help us out with the practicals. You know him very well. And so, children, that's all for today. And in the theory classes online, we will be explaining other things also that you need to know. So with this, we come to the end of today's video session. Okay. So now I have to end the meeting, so I'm going to do that.